Hello students, in this part I am going to explain pointers to structure, and that means how pointers are used to access the structures. And I am going to explain dynamic memory allocation and self-reference structures and linked list. These are the things I am going to explain in this part. So first and foremost, we will see how to access the pointer using a structure variable. So in the previous lectures we have seen pointers use it to access arrays. So whereas, for example, I have taken int I is a normal variable 10. So where int I equal to 10, I have allocated 10 and I have declared another pointer called star p. So that means I have allocated I value. So I have accessed this normal variable with this pointer. So this is how we access a normal variable with a pointer. But how to access a array variable? So int a of 5 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. If at all, I am having 5 members. How many pointers I have declared here? Only one pointer I have declared. What is that pointer? Pt. So let's take pt. What I have done? Pt equal to a, or pt equal to ampersand of a of 0. So I can do this or this. Any statement I can do. So to access whole array, I have used how many pointers? One pointer. To access one variable, I used one pointer. That means using a pointer, I am accessing a normal variable. Using a pointer, I am accessing array variables. Now, we will see how to access structure variable using a pointer. Tell me, what is a pointer to be declared for integer type of variable? To access the integer type of variable, which type of pointer has to be declared? Same type, that is int star p, that is same type of data type of pointer should be declared to access the, to give a link to a integer type of variable. Likewise, for float, it is float. For char, it is character. So likewise, whereas structure variable will have which type of data? Struct, tag name and variable, one variable. So this variable will have which type of data? This is struct tag. So likewise, now I'm going to take the same structure definition and we'll see how the pointer is used to access the structure. Here, if at all I'm having a struct student, int roll number. So let's take, this is my structure. So what is the variable I write? Struct student, s1 is variable for this structure. Then what is the pointer, how to create? What is the data type here? This struct student is a data type. So same data type I have declared and point. How to give a link to this? Same p equal to ampersand of s1. So now we'll see how to access that structure variable using a pointer. Okay. For example, I have given here struct name, member 1, member 2 and so on. So this is the struct. The name is my tag name. So what I have done is struct name. How I have declared struct name is my data type. Star pointer is a pointer to which this variable, this is a normal variable of which one? Struct name type. So star ptr is a which type? It is a pointer for this which type? Struct type. So that means this pointer is used to access the array. Okay, next. So simple example, how to access the members using a pointer. See here some simple example here. Struct student, I have declared a struct student, int roll number, char name, float, average. This is my declaration, that is definition of defining my struct student. So how to declare a variable for this struct student s1, that is struct student s1 21 xyz. This is, I am initializing here only for time being. To make it easy, I am initializing here only. S1 is equal to 21 xyz 23 point. So where 21 is the rule number, xyz is the name, 23.45 is the average. For example, how to declare a pointer for this structure? Same. So what is this struct student is the data type. Star p is the declaration of pointer. And here only I have assigned. So initialized. I have initialized the variable. How I would initialize star p is equal to ampersand of s1. How to assign a value? So p equal to ampersand of s1. So same thing. So assign the ampersand of s1, that is address of s1 to p. So now what happened? P has a link between s1 to p. So now I have a link, that is pointer is assigned to s1. So done. So assignment of pointer is done. Now my thing is to access the variables, that is access the members of this structure by using the pointer. How to do? First we'll see how a normal variable we access by using a normal variable, as well as we'll see using a pointer variable. So here I've accessed the using normal variable s1 dot roll number. You know how to access the variable s1 dot roll number. It prints the now using normal variable. I'll do like this, but using a pointer, how I can do that? Using a pointer, how I can do star p. So star p is a normal value. So star p is the value at that place. So star p, will use star p dot name. Star p dot name. Star p dot name is also prints the same as s1 dot roll number, but it is s1 dot roll number is a normal variable. Star p dot name is a by using printing the name by using a star, that is star p, that is pointer, by using a pointer. Here it is there another one. What is there another one? I have shown this another one. What is this? p-avg, that is p arrow avg. What do you mean by this? P arrow avg is the same thing. What is that? Star p dot avg. Instead of writing star p dot avg, I have written arrow avg. This both notations are same. Instead of writing both star and dot, we have come with a new operator called hyphen, that arrow operator is used instead of star and dot to access members of a structure using a pointer. We use arrow operator. That is clear. Okay, we'll see next one. So that is the thing. So example, accessing the members of the pointer. How to access the members of the pointer? To access the members of the pointer, we use which operator? Arrow operator we use. So in this example, the address of the person, this is address of the, here I've given example, person age weight, main struct person, star person ptr. Person ptr is the pointer which I've created for this person. Next I've assigned the, what I've done is I've initialized the person pointer. So what is that pointer now? What is that person pointer? Is given access to this structure pointer, structure variable. Now what is doing? Enter age ampersand person pointer to AFG. So it is to be address of the particular person, person ptr hyphen avg. To make it is possible, we have to write star person hyphen dot age of, and so we have to write all this. Instead of writing all that, what we are writing? Ampersand percentage ptr. So you have to read the value. That's the reason I've given ampersand. So percentage ptr hyphen, we have to use hyphen percentage. So person ptr to age, person ptr to age, printf enter weight. So scanf percentile f percentage ampersand person ptr to weight. So I'm printing that, displaying that by using person ptr hyphen age person ptr weight. So the return 0. Done. So this is example how to access a member. So see, person ptr age is equivalent to star person ptr dot age, I have already told. So person ptr hyphen weight is equivalent to star person ptr dot weight. Okay, next we'll see. So before going to self-reference structure, we need to know something about this. So see dynamic memory allocation. How dynamic memory allocation does, what is actually dynamic memory is, so arrays are the static memory allocation. Why they are called as arrays or static memory allocation? When I declare array size, that size is static. When I declare the size, that much size of memory only allocated. That means if I declare a of 100, I cannot change, I cannot increase the size, I cannot decrease the size. Once I have declared a of 100, in the execution of program, I cannot change. But to change that value, to make that happen, to dynamically change the size of memory allocated, I am using malloc, that is malloc, calloc, free and realloc. These are called as dynamic memory allocation function. Dynamic memory allocation functions are malloc, calloc, calloc and free. These are four are the dynamic memory allocation function to make it possible of increase the memory size or decrease the memory size while executing the program. That makes it happen to increase your size or decrease your size. So here, first and foremost, malloc is a function. First function is called as memory allocation. The full form is memory allocation. How to declare? Ptr is equal to cache type. What is the cache type? Which type of size you have to allocate? Which type of size you want to allocate? That size is called as cache type. Malloc is size. How much size you want to allocate? So which type of, for example, size is how many bytes to be allocated. Size tells you how many bytes to be allocated. Where cache type is which type of. So this memory allocation to be which type, integer type or float type or character type, which type of data to be allocated, that will be told by a cache type. Cast. So see here example. What is the example again? Float star malloc 100 into, that means 100 means 100 into size of float. So each float occupies 4 bytes. 100 into 4. How many variables will be created? 100 into 4. 100 variables to create 100 variables. We have written 100 into 4. Each one should be of 4. So a total 400 bytes will be created so that I can allocate 100 variables of what float type. So that's the reason I have given 100 into size of float. Sir, instead of giving size of float, you can give directly 4. No sir, you can give, but it changes as per architecture, so we may not know. So to allocate a float type, so first we have said that int in the 16 bit architecture is 2, 32 bit architecture is 4. So it will be changing based upon your architecture. That's the reason to make it as dynamic, so not to change every time. So size of float is very good option to write. Okay, the above statement allocates 400 bytes memory. It is because the size of float is 4 bytes and the pointer ptr holds the address of the first byte in the allocation of memory. The expression results in the null pointer if a memory is not connected, cannot allocate if at all. So ptr, when I have given ptr is equal to cache type memory allocation size, if at all the memory is unable to allocate, the ptr will be null value. I can check whether allocated or not by using a null. If ptr is equal to null, that means the memory is not allocated. By checking this only, you have to go for further allocating or deallocating or doing any work on your memory. So next we'll see calloc. So calloc, so the name of calloc stands for continuous memory allocation. What is the difference between malloc and calloc? Is both are same. Malloc is memory allocation, calloc is also memory allocation. Both functions are used to allocate the memory, but malloc is memory allocation of which they'll not be like block by block. They'll be only all the variables. But they have allocated 400. The 400 will be separate bytes. Whereas here, if I write here in calloc, the 4 bytes one time, 4 bytes one way, block by block, 4 bytes one block, 4 bytes one block, 4 bytes one block, like that. So same syntax, 4 bytes one block. So that means block by block memory will be allocated here in the calloc. So whereas in malloc, only one single byte will be allocated for each memory allocation. That is the difference between calloc and malloc. So what is the syntax of calloc? Or ptr is equal to cache type calloc n here. What is n here? We don't have explicitly n size, but here have explicitly n size. What is the reason? So n number of block sizes will be allocated. That's the reason I've written n. So example, ptr is equal to float star calloc of 25 blocks of memory will be allocated of which each block of which type, which size float, that is 4 bytes of 25 blocks will be allocated. Okay, the above statements allocate continuous spare memory of 25 elements of type float. Okay, this is about calloc. So free, so what is the use of free? Is to free up your memory. Already you have allocated with the calloc and malloc, so to free up, to delete up the memory allocation that is allocated by calloc or malloc, we use free. So dynamically allocated memory created with either calloc or malloc does not get freed on their own. To free up that, explicitly to free up, we release the space by using the free function. So what is the syntax? Just free up. What is the ptr? So what is ptr, sir? Here ptr is a by which pointer you have allocated, that pointer you have to give here. By that, the pointer will be freed up, the memory will be deallocated. Okay, that is about calloc. So next is realloc. What is in the realloc? If at all, if you have allocated a memory using calloc or a malloc, you cannot change it. So to change or to reallocate, to increase the value or to decrease the value of sizes, we use realloc. Ptr realloc ptr comma x, where ptr is a normal which ptr you have allocated the size using malloc or calloc, you have to write this ptr, the old ptr, and x is the number of size to be decreased, reallocated. So if I write a minus x, it is be decreased. If I write x, it will be increased. That is to reallocate the value, to reallocate a memory size, to decrease a memory size, to increase a memory size, we use a calloc. Okay, these are the four functions. What are the four functions we have seen? Malloc, Calc, pre, and realloc. These are the functions. These are the four functions are the standardized dynamic memory allocation function. Dynamic memory allocation function. To use these functions, you have to add a header file called ash include. That is, include is include function. Stdlib. Stdlib. Standard library function you have to add to use these four functions. These are predefined functions. These four are the predefined functions which enables you to allocate a memory dynamically. When you are using that function, you have to use stdlib standardized header file. Okay, so next we'll see how a dynamic memory allocation uses structure. So struct, by using struct, how to do that? Same thing here. What is the syntax for malloc here? It should be typecast, but instead of typecast, which typecast? Struct person. So where that there is a struct person, so the struct person we have used, malloc is a function to allocate n into size of struct. So each have which type? Struct type. So that's the reason, struct person. So how much size to be allocated by this? Which typecast? Typecast means which type of data to be allocated. Here which type of data? My data type. What is the data type here? Struct person is my data type. That's the reason, struct type is my data type. That's the reason I have typecast with using which type? Struct type. Struct person type. So next, malloc is a function. N is the number of sizes to be allocated. So each size, number of sizes. The n is the number of sizes, but each size which should be which type? Struct person type. That's the reason again. That's everything apart from this, everything is same. So using a pointer, I have to access a variable ptr plus I name, ptr plus I age. So ptr is a pointer. This iphone is a, so what is the arrow symbol to access the members of the person? So a ptr plus I name, ptr iphone name is the name of this person. Why did I given I? So I may not know how many number of, so n is the number of persons I have to allocate. N is the number of persons values to be allocated. That's the reason I have given I. So I have access by I using this person. So you see, to access first person, ptr to name, ptr to age. For second person, ptr plus 1, ptr plus 1 to age. Why? What is this, sir? This is arithmetic, pointer arithmetic. To increase plus 1, we go with the next address. To increase plus 1 with a pointer, do we go with the next address value? Plus 2, next. To increase that address value, I have given a pointer arithmetic increment operation with a 1 or 2. That is the reason I have given I value, and it will be automatically incremented, and it will take the values and it will be printing the values. The same thing I use to print the value, same thing I use to read the value. You are given a percentile as percentile D for name, it is name, and it is age. So I have given ampersand here. So I have given, I didn't give ampersand in the printf statement. That's the difference between that and this. Okay, next we'll see linked list. What do you mean by linked list? So here we know that arrays are linear list where elements are stored in the continuous memory allocation. Continuous memory allocation. So if I allocate a continuously memory allocation, there is a disadvantage when I'll allocate a continuously. What happens is if I don't have enough memory to allocate all this array values. For example, I want to store 1000 array values. I don't have 1000 array values at one place. So what is one? Why are you asking one place? The memory 1000 values has to be stored it continuously, not somewhere. If at all array stores anywhere in the memory, it is okay. I can store, if at all, if I have 1000 memory locations in somewhere, I can store it. But if at all I don't have 1000 memory location at one place, where do I go? The array will not be allocated. We will get error. For that, we are going with another linear type of thing called a linked list. A linked list is a linear type of list where it will have two parts. What is that? Data part and next part. Next part is nothing. Link part, data part and link part. Here in the data part, I will store the same way. How I will store in the array? I will store the value. In the link part, what I will store is the next link. Next link to the next value. Next link to the next value. Like that, if I do like that, no need to store all the values continuously. All the values continuously, because I have a link to the next variable where it has been stored. Link to the next variable it has to store. Link to the next variable where it has stored. By this link, I will know where the next variable has stored. By this next, here we will have a next link. So by this, I will store I'll see the next variable where it has been stored. I'll see the next variable where it has been stored. So that means by using a linked list, I now need to store all the elements in one place continuously. So your linked list enables you to store your memory, store your values anywhere in the memory where the free space is available, where the free space is available. And you have another advantage also. You can add your elements dynamically or delete elements dynamically. But whereas in array, if you declare A of 10, that means you can only have 10 elements. You cannot increase the size, you cannot decrease the size. But in the linked list, you can increase the size, you can decrease the size, you can delete the elements, you can add the element. That is another advantage. What will be there in linked list? So we'll have a data part and linked. Data part, link. Data part, link. So the last will have a null because it is not linking to any other. So it is not having any other value at that place. So that means, Vital, if I have another value, I'll ask to store this address into this variable. So this is a representation. Why we use a linked list? Arrays can be used to store a linear data in a similar type, but arrays have following limitation. What is the following limitation? The size of array is fixed. So we must know upper limit of the member of the elements in advance. That means, so if to store how much elements, the last limit we have to store, maximum limit we have to store, and we have to store. But here in the linked list, no need to remember. First, if at all, if you are going to increase goes on increasing based upon your size. So the allocated memory is equal to the upper limit irrespective of usage. So inserting a new element in an array of element is expensive because room has to be existing, elements have to be then shifted. So next element has to be shifted. But here, no need to. In linked list, I can add directly in the middle of the list, and I can add at last of the list, anywhere in the linked list. That is advantage. For example, in the system, if we maintain the stored list ID, so 1000, 1001, 1010, 1050, 2000, 240. If you want to insert a new ID of 1005 in middle, where in between, so how I can add? I can add directly in arrays. I cannot add, but in linked list, I can add anywhere in the linked list. So deletion also can be done easily whenever I want to do it. That is also one of the advantages using linked list. So advantages. So ease of insertion and deletion. We have seen. What is easy? Easily we can insert and we can delete. Size of the list does not need mentioned at the beginning of the program. Goes on incrementing dynamically whenever we want to increment. So certainly dynamic memory allocation in the deallocation, memory allocation, deallocation. As a linked list does not have a size limit, we can go adding new node and increase the size of the list any event. So that's one of the advantage. Okay. These are the advantages of the linked list over the arrays. Okay, next we'll see self-reference structure. What is a self-reference structure? Self-reference structure is a structure which has a referencing to same structure. That is called a self-reference structure. That is here. So here I have a struct node int data, char data to struct node star in link. Link is a link. Again, it is linking to same. Where struct node is of which type? Again, same type. So it is again linking to the same type. If at all, if I link a structure to the same structure definition, that is called as self-reference structure. Self-reference structure. Where we use the self-reference structure is, see here. This is node. This is another node. This is of which type OB1. This is of which type OB2. Both are which type? The same of struct node type. So this is OB1 is also struct node type. OB2 also struct node type. This link has to be redirected to which type? This is a link. Yes, it is a link. But what is this pointer? This pointer has to point which type of data again? The same type of data. Which same type of data? OB1, OB2 of type data. OB2, which type of data? Struct node type data. So that's the reason. Struct node link. Data 1, data 2. This is a data 1. This is data 2. This is data 1, data 2. And this is a link. This is a link. This link is linking again. This is link is pointing to which type of data? Again, this total node, which node? This is a node. This is node 1, this is node 2. So, but this node 2 of which type again? The same struct node type. That means struct node type. So, this is also struct node type. This is also struct node type. But this pointer to point which type again? Node. What node this? This is which type of node again? Struct node type. That's the reason I have given struct node. Starlink. So how to declare a pointer? Starlink. Struct node is which type? This is which type again? Struct node type. That's the reason I've written struct node and starlink. That means here pointer is pointing again to which type of data type? The same type of data type. That's the reason. These are called as self-referential structure. If a structure is referencing to same definition or same template, same template data type, that type of data is called as self-referential structure. The pointer inside the same data type is again pointing to the same type of data, that is called as self-referential structure. Okay. So up to this, we have completed all the pointers and structure. Okay. Thank you.